What's up, guys? This is Fates of Warren. I apologize for the lack of recent content. I have been extremely busy in school. By extremely busy, I mean I have been doing my best to keep myself from failing my classes, and school really took precedence over my YouTube account, so I wasn't able to get any new videos or get any new reviews up. The reason why, of course, is because I've changed my style up from the just talking to a video to actually more complex stuff with editing and making scripts and stuff for that. And that's the problem. It takes time to do these things, and I just have not had time to write up a script for my next video, or or do anything of that sort. I apologize for that. I am really, really sorry about all that, and I wish I could have gotten more up. Unfortunately, I'm at the mercy of how much time I have. So. There's something wrong with it. This here. Take a look. I need to edit my channel description, because it has listed as Awaken the Guardian as the next review, which is not correct. I've already reviewed Awaken the Guardian, and I've also already reviewed Looks Down in the Gathering Shadow by Exhausted Prayer. Thank you very much, Colby Stearns, for requesting that. The next requested album that I'll review will be Taken by Force, which was requested by 1983 Wrathchild. Thank you very much for subscribing, by the way. That'll be my next review on underrated metal classics, and followed by that will be Toxic Think This, which was requested by Brain Thrasher. Thank you for reminding me of that one. It's been a while since I've listened to that album, but that was one of my favorite tech thrash albums. 1989 is a really good year for tech thrash and prog metal. And also some of the beginnings of technical death metal as well, because Atheist had their first album released during that, their first album, Piece of Time, to release during that year. But yeah, so, next video should be, my next video is mostly going to be, focusing on, going back to British Steel. Just the problem was during my British Steel review, there were some things I did not get to, I didn't get to talk about the musicians enough, because I really do not, that's one of the things that was also seemed a little bit strange to me. It's like they didn't put as much effort into the musicianship as they did on previous records. I kind of touched on it in my review, but I didn't really go as in-depth into it as I would have liked. But once I get that video done, I'll be done with British Steel completely, and then I'll move on to Point of Entry, and then get on with, and I'll finish up the rest of the Judas Priest discography. That's mostly what's going on. My next Metal Atrocities will be the album Roots by Sepultura, and then after that will be one that's a bit of more recent memory to us, Elude Divinium Insanus by Morbid Angel. I will be taking requests for Metal Atrocities. If you want me to review an album that you think is particularly bad, just post a comment down here. Or one that's particularly good. Either one. If you think it's an basic, but basically, yeah. I'll just set my criteria here. Once again, underrated metal. The two series I have going, as you know, are Underrated Metal Classics and Metal Atrocities. With Underrated Metal Classics, it has to score. Okay, here's the criteria. First of all, it has to score at least 90% or higher on my at least 90% or higher on my ratings scale. Because for me, 90% plus equals a classic album. So 90% or higher. So if it scores a 90% or higher, which means I really enjoyed it, I will definitely review it. If it doesn't, I unfortunately won't. But I will still take a look at it if you recommend it to me. Two, of course, it has to be metal, and I would still recommend, and again, I'd still recommend that you, and again, I still recommend that you visit the Metal Archives for reference. That doesn't mean I'm not going to accept it. I mean, there's some bands that are not on the Metal Archives that I think should be on the Metal Archives, but, and there's also some bands that are on the Metal Archives that I think shouldn't be on the Metal Archives, because there's a couple of, I'm really not exactly sure what the criteria is for a deathcore band to get in, because almost all deathcore is not particularly metal to me. So, and I probably won't even review those as is, because I'm not a fan of deathcore or nu metal or glam metal. I might accept glam metal, although more likely for Metal Atrocities than I would for Underrated Metal Classics, again, because I'm not a huge fan of glam metal, but at all, really. There's maybe one or two bands from that scene I like. I kind of like Dokken, but I'm really not sure if I would call them glam metal. I call them more of a heavy metal, kind of hard rock band. But I'm not a huge fan of glam metal as is. I think it's mostly a way too commercial. But yeah, just once again, if you're gonna request anything, look it up on the Metal Archives, and just for reference, and if you think it's something that I might like, then go right ahead and request it. That's it, and that's about it. That's mostly about it for Underrated Metal Classics. Now, from Underrated Metal Classics, it specifically has to be a metal album. So, in other words, if it's a non-metal album by a metal band that I think is particularly good, I won't review it I'm mostly focusing on underrated metal albums, not underrated albums by metal bands. If that was the case, I'd be reviewing. I'm not saying that albums like Opeth's Heritage, which I really liked, I don't consider it a classic, but I did really like it. And an album like that, Opeth's Heritage, I mean, I wouldn't review that because it's not technically metal. It's more progressive rock with some metal influences. I mean, you can hear them still in there, but it's more progressive rock, progressive hard rock. But yeah, an album like that I wouldn't review, really. But an album like, if it's like an album like, say, underrated, I mean, it either has to be by a band that's relatively obscure, or it's by a band that is not so obscure, But they have an album that's not particularly as well known among their catalog. Like Scorpions. Scorpions, for instance, Taken by Force, is not exactly as well known among their catalog as, say, well, shoot, say some of their 80s albums, like, say, Blackout, for instance. It's not nearly as well known as, like, Blackout. But it's not particularly an album that I would, if you're gonna, like, request something like that. Another album that I wanted to get to was, Dream Theater's first album, When Dream and Day Unite. I think that album is particularly underrated, mostly because Charlie Dominici is on vocals, and I don't think that he might not have the most male voice, but he still doesn't sound bad at all, and I think he's just fine as a vocalist. That was one I wanted to get to. But there's some other ones that I wanted to get to as well. But if you have any, once again, if you have a request, just place it down in the comments, either on my channel or on this video, or any of my videos for that, any of my underrated metal classics videos for that matter. I'll take requests, no problem with that. Same thing with Metal Atrocities. You can request anything that's particularly bad. With Metal Atrocities, I'm a bit more lenient though. Although it still has to be from a band. With Metal Atrocities, it doesn't necessarily need to be a metal album. It has to be an album by a band that either is or once was metal. Which, again, you can still use. I would still recommend you use the Metal Archives for that. It has to be an album that was particularly bad. For something to be reviewed on Metal Atrocities, it has to score 30% or lower. It has to be particularly cheesy or bad or poorly done in some way. So yeah, that's mostly. I mean, so like, as I said, I'm gonna be doing Roots next time. That album to me is a particularly bad album. It's kind of one of those albums in which it kind of fell prey to 90s thrash. What a lot of 90s thrash bands did. It's kind of fell prey to sort of Metallica syndrome in a ways, and that's mostly what I'm gonna be talking about. And of course, Morbid Angel's Allude to Venom and Sanus. We all know how bad that one turned out. There's a few albums that I won't review. I am not going to review Saint Anger. I will not review Saint Anger in any way at all. The reason why I'm not going to review Saint Anger is because every single person on Earth has pretty much said almost everything that needs to be said on that album, and almost every single person on Earth hates it. Well, not every single person, but almost every single person on Earth hates that album, and I'm like, there's really not much else I can contribute to that, more than what most everybody already knows, and it's kind of gone a while from now. Like, Allude to Venom and Sanus is more of recent memory, and when I reviewed Lulu, that was pretty much, like, very soon after Lulu was released. But yeah, it was not an album that, I mean, you know, the stuff that's of more recent memory. There's some stuff. The thing is, though, there's some stuff that's been so bad, that's, like, so bad that it's kind of faded into obscurity, sort of. I will be focusing a lot on how the Thrashers kind of commercialized their sound. Oh, another one. I won't do Risk. The reason why I won't do Risk by Megadeth, the reason why is because although I think it's not good, I don't think it's bad enough to be considered an atrocity. I think that there's still some redeemable moments on that record. It's just it's not really awful. It's just not particularly that good. And so I'm not going to review Risk, and I'm not going to review Saint Anger, so don't request Saint Anger. I'm not going to review Load or Reload either, because same thing with Risk. It's not particularly as bad enough to be reviewed. It has to be bad enough to be reviewed. I'm going to be mostly focusing on mostly going to be focusing on bands that change their style, make drastic changes in their style, mostly to get more commercial success. There's actually going to be a lot of bands from the new wave of British heavy metal on this. Now, hear me out on this. The reason why is because I'm going to go over exactly what happened. Because we all know the new wave of British heavy metal kind of died as quickly as it came in. As quickly as it took for it to get big. I'm going to go over that. Some albums that I probably will review in the future. I'll probably be reviewing Diabolus and Musica by Slayer, the one that almost everybody hates. Hysteria by Def Leppard. Seriously, there's a lot of people that try to say Def Leppard's not a metal band in any way. I keep trying to tell them, listen to their first album. Their first album was metal. It was after that when they kind of started to go hard rock directions, and then after the second album, and then the third album they went completely commercial. That was more like really washed up hard rock rather than good hard rock like the second one was. And then the fourth album, Hysteria, I might review just because I absolutely regret asking for it for Christmas 2 years ago. That was completely my fault. I was kind of more open at the time, a bit more open at the time to what I was listening to, and then, I recall listening to it, and I just thought it was so boring. I will definitely be reviewing. I'll definitely be reviewing Hysteria. I'll definitely be reviewing Hysteria. But you know, if there's an album that you think is particularly bad by a band that is or once was metal, go ahead and request it. I'm completely open to suggestions, and if you want something that's reviewed that's either really good or really bad, you can even leave a comment posting as many as you want of each. If there's an album that you think is particularly good or particularly bad, just request it. There's really no cutoff date or anything like that. The only real cutoff date I can say is has to be released after 1970, because that's when I say that metal officially was created, because that's when Black Sabbath's first album, officially was fully stated as a genre, because that's when Sabbath's first album was released in 1970 with their eponymous debut album. But if you have anything that you'd like me to review, just request it. And it's not in my description anymore, but as I said, I will start to do movie reviews. I just want to see how it works, because I'm going to start out with The Last Airbender, because I particularly hate that film, especially since I was a fan of the show, and that Shyamalan just raped it. But yeah, I'm going to be reacting to that. I'm also gonna think of doing, like, weekly movie reviews of films that I go to see in theaters, which might not be as often during my while the times I'm in college as I am when I'm in on co-op, because when I'm on co-op I'll have a lot more free time to go do stuff like that. So yeah, I did go to see The Artist yesterday, and I thought it was pretty good. It was different, but it was good. I can't say if it truly deserved to be the best picture, because I haven't seen almost everything that was nominated. I'm gonna try to go see good films as often as I can. I will mostly be looking up on Rotten Tomatoes to see what most critics and stuff are thinking of it.
There's
some films I'm gonna check out no matter what. Like, I'm gonna check out The Avengers and The Dark Knight Rises and Amazing Spider-Man and the Star Trek sequel when they all come out, because those films I'm gonna see no matter what. But for the most part I'm gonna mostly try to see good films. There was one film I wanted to see that came out last week called The Hunger Games, which I've heard was good. My brother read the book. I haven't read the book. I'm not much of a reader, unfortunately, but that was one I wanted to see. So, but yeah, it's mostly going to be kind of like a vlog review. I might do a kind of preview as well, where I basically go over my expectations, what I'm thinking about it, and, do I think it will be a good film or not so good? That's mostly what I'll try to do when I do reviews like that. It's mostly just going to be going up on and just saying what I thought of the movie. So yeah, I'm gonna do an experiment like sometime, probably after I've reviewed Point of Entry. I'll be reviewing The Last Airbender. That might take longer to get done. I'm gonna try to get one review done a week. One of those full length reviews done a week. Try to get all scripted and edited and all the parts recorded and stuff like that. Get that all done within a week, and do all that. So that's mostly about all I have to say. I'm gonna correct my description on my description box to put the stuff that in the correct order. And but yeah, so that's about it. Next album on the Fates Warning series should be No Exit, obviously, because I just reviewed Awaken the Guardian. So I'll go on to No Exit. I'll probably review Perfect Symmetry probably towards the end of my work term, if I can. I'm really looking forward to reviewing Perfect Symmetry. That might have to be a multi-part review because there's so much I want to talk about that album, because I really like that album. That is one of my favorite albums. It is my favorite album by Fates Warning, and it's one of my all-time favorite albums. So that one's going to take longer than usual, but longer than the usual one, so I'm probably going to divide it into a multi-part review. But yeah, I'm open to requests for some movie reviews, although I don't know. Actually, no. Don't request movie reviews. Make that. Movie reviews are just going to be kind of an occasional thing, more likely. It's going to be more of something that I have an interest in, rather than like random movie reviews. Because I don't want to be a movie reviewer. I want to be a music reviewer that occasionally reviews movies. So, I guess I'll see you guys later, and take care, keep it metal, and, well, adios.